Hi everyone, welcome to enjoythemusic.com and enjoythemusic.tv. We're here with a surprise guest, Michael Mercer. He's on the telephone with us. He's been really busy. He's been running all over CES. So, hi Michael, how you doing?
Hey, Mr. Steve Rochlin and my Enjoy the Music family. I am completely elated, to the least. This has probably been the most fun I have had at CES, I might venture to say, actually ever.
Wow.
Because not only have I not even split my time, it's the first CES, having come up under, you know, in the high-end audio industry, as you know, but having worked in both the music and audio, I usually spend my time at the high-end audio together with the Arts Park and the Venetian, but now I spend most of my time at the convention center because I'm so focused on versatile audio. And to me, the biggest story, and it was the biggest story in many ways, was my dear friend Alex Rossin, CEO of Odyssey and the Odyssey team, finally introduced, and let's call it a more attainable state-of-the-art headphone called the LA EL-8, and it is a open and closed planar magnetic headphone, which also has a tilt talk feature and two new technologies incorporated. At $700, people have been asking me nonstop, well, where does this put my LCD series, right? Steve,
right.
You and I both have an LCD 2 or 3. This is a completely different experience. I would say that to compare them is almost unfair. However, I will say that having lived with prototypes for a while and being very tight-lipped, the open back is super, and it's like an LCD's little brother, but it's built so well and it looks so great. It's on a single pivot point like the B&O H6.
Right.
And it's a wonderful, wonderful body when you hold it in your hand, kind of like, you know, remember how cameras used to feel in your
hands?
And it's so comfortable. I actually, it didn't put me to sleep, but the last night I pulled an all-night listening session. I couldn't stop listening to it. I eventually went to sleep listening to some mini music. But I tell you this, the closed-back version of the EL-8, this is what I want to say to everybody listening. And I've been, as Stephen knows, I've been doing this a long time.
Yep.
And I may be an excitable guy, but this product literally just delegated about 12 to 14 pairs in my collection to friends and family.
Wow.
I no longer need more than half my collection because I have the LCD series and the EL-8, which is very easy. Very comfortable to walk around with. It's such a great step in the right direction for them. There's going to be some huge, there's going to be one particular retailer that's very huge. Let's just say with a big bite out of a fruit that we all love. Odyssey is going to be available at stores like that too. And there, as a matter of fact, they also introduced a new Jack Amp, Steven. Did you know that?
I heard about it. Scott Hull, we were just with him. He hinted on it. Why don't you tell us a little bit more about it?
So the Deck Arts is, if you remember, it's a wonderfully, from an aesthetic standpoint, it is a completely modern, contemporary piece with brushed aluminum. It just looks so sexy, and it is a powerhouse. You know, it's got a DAC, it's got a headphone amp capable of driving whatever Odyssey you want, and it is an actual Odyssey. It's the first Odyssey headphone amp DAC, and I'll tell you, most reviewers will say, I think this and I think that, but I'm going to instead tell you a quick story. I ran up to the booth, and of course, you know, the Odyssey people are like family to me. But I had to put in my own source, right? So we should have
right.
a reference. So I literally pulled out their laptop,
yep.
plugged in my Astralink current AK240, and put in Reckon Iffy, you know, nice underground shutter
mm-hmm.
checkout. And I start dancing with my LCD XDs on their clothes. And the 65-year-old woman who's next to me, and honestly, I didn't notice her at first, and with her wonderful husband, she starts tugging on my shirt. and I think it's Warren or one of my boys from 360. So I kind of turned around like, leave me alone. It's this wonderful older woman. So, and she reminded me of my Aunt Eunice. So automatically, you know, I just, my head was up and I said, oh my God, I'm so sorry. If you need any help, you know, my best friend, I mean, this is, she's a CEO of this company. And you know what she said, Stephen? I said, or if I could do anything for you. And you know what? Her name was Janet. Janet, if you end up listening, because she says I gave her all the information about Enjoy the Music and 360. Janet and her husband, what a pleasure it was to meet them. This woman's 65, and all she said to me, I said, is there anything I can do for you? And she says, and I love this, Stephen, get this.
Yeah.
She looked at my name tag and said, Michael Mercer, I want to feel like you do right now. And you know what I did?
Gave her the headphones.
I put the headphones on her head, and I have a short video of her dancing, a 65-year-old woman, okay, a Jewish woman like my good Jewish mother from New York, boogieing and just losing herself in the music. And then her husband, who is an oncologist,
yeah,
a retired oncologist from New York, who, and just, you know, he we call him an audiophile. He owns Macintosh, he owns B&W,
yep,
he put on the LCD freeze. And within a half an hour, they bought an LCD, an LCD 3, and pre-ordered two of the new Odysseys. And this was the cream of the story, Stephen. So there was no selling about it. It was all about the music. It was all about the feeling. It was all about the connection.
Yes.
The human connection.
Yes.
This woman, Janet, said, she's not an audiophile, okay? She looked at me and she said, I'm still moving inside. That was so emotively powerful. And you know that I write about that a lot in my reviews, where people like measurement, I want to react to music.
Michael, you are such a mensch, and that's what I love about you. You're just this great, awesome guy that's fun to be around.
And, well, we had a really huge moment, too. My cousin Kenny Gould does a lot of projects for Stevie Wonder. So we got Stevie a pair of Odyssey LCDXs, and Stevie came by the booth yesterday.
Woo!
It was amazing, and it was so wonderful to have him there. Unfortunately, I wasn't there, but of course, I got the call. My cousin had set it up, and I want to give a shout-out to Kenny, who's going to be listening to this. Kenny, we hope you get well. You know, Kenny's been sick and isn't able to be here. I just had a blast. I'll tell you a couple of quick things.
Yep.
Macintosh has saved Wadia Digital.
Really?
And what I mean by this is, and I say this because I love Wadia, because you and I both know that Wadia Digital introduced the audio file to the iPod through their iDock.
Yes.
The first dock that was enabled people to get digital access to the iPod. Well, we know and they introduced the DAC as a component along with Apogee, but I think what happened is they got lost in the Fine Sounds umbrella. And we walk into the Wadia Macintosh room, because as you know, at 360, we had the scoop on the MHA-100, the FB-100. Next thing you know, I'm looking at a Wadia preamp/headphone amp DAC. Gorgeous.
Ooh.
So I'm going to be reporting on soon. And we'll also be covering a wonderful looking updated. So the D-100, Stephen, you know I own it. It's my reference DAC.
Mm-hmm.
Now they, of course, come out with the D51, right, Steve? Why do they got to do this?
They like to tease you, just like you're teasing me now on the phone.
Right? Well, hey, look.
I know, right?
Oh, he was a good audio crack dealer. He was a great audio crack dealer. So I was very happy to see Wadia Digital get an infusion. And that infusion came through Macintosh. I don't know who came up with that idea, but I got to give them real props. That it was a wonderful vibe in that room. You and I both know Mark and Colin Carter at Colin Carter Import.
Mm-hmm.
Finally, Unison Research, by reference to the photo stages, you know, they introduced their prototype headphone amp. I was actually apprehensive about listening to it because the gentleman said he wanted me to review it. I said, as you know, I wrote the first review of the photo stage, and I said, well, thinking about the story I'm going to be writing for you about the Soul Adventure this time, because, folks, usually I have with the hotel room. Usually I have everything. I literally came in a friend's car. I have a rucksack on. I have my headphones in my hair. And I'm just like all over the place. Just, it feels, you know what it feels for? It feels for like
a party.
Rocky Mountain. Yeah,
you're like a personal portable party machine.
I had a couple dancing on the taxi line this morning when I had to leave Planet Hollywood.
So I had no, no had way. I don't believe it. Yeah.
So I got to say that I want to let all the listeners know that for all of you watching or just listening, and I'm sorry I can't give you guys video, and Steven's been very, very
oh, stop,
Swiss Army knife about this and letting me talk. Steven, this is not easy. He makes it look easy, he makes it fun, but the truth is that Steven not only invests a lot of his money, but more important to me, his time, his care, his love, his passion. It's my honor to call him my friend. It's my honor to be a part of the Enjoy the Music team. And it's been my honor to represent that team while I've been here, as well as Audio 360s and other. And I'll tell you, I wish I could tell your folks what I'm going to actually cover in the KJM report, Enjoy the Music. But I'm working on a title. Did I tell you what that was?
Yes.
Well, now it can work because we all know this. We all know the great Hunter S., the late Hunter S. Thompson in Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas.
Yep.
So I figured, I'm bringing a camping pack and my headphones out on Fear and Loathing. Well, it was Fear and Loathing because I left my $1,600 or whatever, $1,500 Odyssey LCD XDs at a restaurant last night.
Yep.
Went there 8 o'clock in the morning, got them back, and then left them at the cafe right in the middle of the, you know, when you right when you get to the Venetian Tower.
Note to self, anyone listening, do not give Michael something to hold on to.
Or, I can even elaborate further, because this is the big thing. Next time, there are these great little GPS transponders that, like, you know, from, you know, that you can track people with or not track things.
Oh, I'm very familiar with those, yes.
If anyone wants to donate to the Mike Mercer so he doesn't lose any audio gear fund, I am happy to accept donations in the form of GPS transponders for all my gear. But I got the headphones back twice, and now I've just locked it in my friend's car because they won't come out again. I won't push bait. But I'll tell you, again, Odyssey, the Unify Research is great. My good friend, my dear friend, Craig Kalman, the chairman of Warner Electric Atlantic and the president of Atlantic Records, has been here for the panel and for the various things. And I can't give away too much, but let's just say that the private Odyssey party, which was hosted by Subpack, which, Stephen, do you know about Subpack?
Yes, I do, actually.
Well, the Subpack guys, you know, are close to Alex. And
they're pretty cool, as I've heard or recall.
Let me tell you. They've improved upon it so much that when I got up, I was listening to the new ELA Odyssey open with the Subpack, which everybody is a backpack with a bass transducer that literally, you know, moves your body like you're in a club. Because the Silent Wave, which we all know is a wireless multi headphone situation where people are hearing the same music through a wireless network.
Okay.
What you're always missing is that visceral impact of like a function one system, you know, or a phase-on system. And with the Subpack, we could literally throw an outlaw rave in the middle of a city and no one would hear it. And it was so exciting. Alex Ross and that DJ Freak Nasty on the ones and twos, spinning all vinyl.
I read about that. By the way, you keep making me more and more jealous. I don't know whether to hug you or to slap you.
Well, I will say this. I miss you the whole time, but I really missed you when I was talking to Freak Nasty because I told him about how you had to hear the Dirt record so much you bought it for me.
Well, of course.
I've had that record forever.
And this was before Pharrell Williams. I mean, he wasn't even... There was no happy, but You know, that was an album you said you wanted. It's Nerd Lap Dance on vinyl, on DJ vinyl. And this is before Pharrell Williams, anybody really, he got big, we'll call it. That's with Happy and all that. This is before that, I hunted it, I found it, and I shipped it to you.
He did, and I will say this is what I love about Steven. So Steven needed to hear this record and knew I had, it just us both being DJs at one point, knew I would have had the record, but I gave that record away a long ago, and he needed to hear it in Newport. And remember when he came out with the champagne? But I want to tell you, it's been that vibe here, and I'm very much looking forward to Newport. I'm very much looking forward to everything else. And I'll tell you this. Usually CES, by right now, I want to get the part by French, the H out of here. But I'm going to go up to the 29th floor and see some good friends and go with, oh, by the way, Thurston has also, you know, revamped the person, Doug Person Audio, the headphone company. They've done a wonderful job.
Yep, Thurston Loesch of iFi Audio.
Yep, and a big shout out to iFi Audio, the IGFD and the Micro has been doing many things, which that's probably going to be a big part of a future piece I'll be doing for you after Fear and Loathing at CES. But for now, I got to get up and get listening to some new music. But let me say, to all that everyone, really, I'm not blowing smoke past Steven so that he can feel better about himself. Steven inspires me. Not only to stay passionate, not only to keep energetic, but to keep positive, and he doesn't sleep. We have that in common. So anyone, really, from the depths of my heart, Stephen, thank you so much for hosting, you know, and giving people this type of outlet. We need more of this. And you know I love you, and I'm going to finish my report ASAP when we get back. We're driving back to Northern California, so it will take me much longer than usual.
Well, enjoy the drive and enjoy the music.
Thank you, and goodbye, everybody.
All right, goodbye, everyone. Goodbye, Michael. As I keep telling people, there's always workarounds. Anyway, that was Michael Mercer with Audio 360, with Positive Feedback Magazine, and of enjoythemusic.com. So we appreciate Michael coming on, and as always, in the end, what really matters, I'm Stephen Rock at enjoythemusic.com, enjoythemusic.tv. What really matters is that you enjoy the music.